Getting started with Ultivar Process ATV600. Hello, today we will guide you through the installation, wiring, and commissioning of your Ultivar Process ATV600. Unpack the drive and verify that it has not been damaged. Scan the QR code in front of the drive to get your product information, technical documentation, and error codes explanations. Verify that the mains voltage value is compatible with the product. For the power part, we will follow this diagram. KM1, line contactor. T1, transformer. Q1, circuit breaker. Short circuit protection device for the motor. Q2, circuit breaker. Short circuit protection device for the primary of the transformer. Q3, circuit breaker. Short circuit protection device for the secondary of the transformer. Verify that the upstream protective devices are compatible with the product. Install your ATV600. The product has to be mounted vertically as shown in the Getting Started, along with other mechanical and environmental constraints. The drive is designed to be used in a controlled indoor environment. Tighten the 4 fixation screws in each corner of your product. Let's start the wiring by removing the cover located under the control block by unscrewing the 4 captive screws. We start by wiring the ground cables. For tightening torques, refer to the product nameplate or to the product installation manual. Then, the power supply connection. And finally, the motor cables. To improve electromagnetic compatibility, please use shielded cables to connect the motor to the drive. Verify that the switch is on default position SRC mode. On the control part, we perform the same operation with both potentiometer for speed reference and DI for run order. To improve electromagnetic compatibility, please use shielded cables for analogic and digital parts and keep them separate. Keep the power and the control cables separate to improve the electromagnetic compatibility. Once the wiring is done, replace the cover on the drive. Tighten the 4 captive screws. Before switching on, use the checklist available on the product installation manual. Start with the mechanical part installation. Continue by checking the electrical installation. Finish by checking the covers and seals. Upon first power on, the graphic display terminal displays the language selection screen. Let's choose English. In this video, we set access level to standard. The first menu available is Simply Start, where you will find most of the basic settings. You have to set the motor parameters. Motor Standard. Nominal Motor Power. Nominal Motor Voltage. Nominal motor current. Nominal motor frequency. Nominal motor speed. Maximum frequency. Once all these parameters are set, you will have to perform an auto-tuning procedure, allowing the drive to refine the motor characteristics. This will create a small noise in the motor, which is totally normal. If you modify the value of one or more parameters after having performed auto-tuning, the value of auto-tuning status resets to not done, and you must re-perform auto-tuning. The last operation to perform is setting the drive according to the application requirements. In this example, an acceleration time of 3 seconds, a deceleration time of 3 seconds. And a high speed limited to 40 Hertz. You can now start your motor. You can check the status of your ATV630 with the LEDs. Refer to the table above to check the LED's status. Also, scan the QR code on the red screen or refer to the product programming manual to get the error code troubleshooting. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.